Hey guys, so I wanted to share another really powerful idea that's super simple and super effective. We have all dealt with heartbreak, right? Like one of the major tenets of Buddhism is that life is suffering, and we have all suffered. Everyone you encounter has suffered. We know this, it's a cliche, we talk about it all the time. But in that suffering is an incredible opportunity and choice. So to tell you a little backstory about me and my own life, right? So a couple years ago, I tore both pecs after a lifetime of abusing my body, and we struggled to find a surgeon. And I was in two slings for months and months and months. And I had thought I had found a surgeon. We went there that day. For various reasons, the surgery didn't happen, and I was heartbroken. And the next day, I went to the park because nature is my therapy, and I was just walking alone. And I couldn't drive there because I didn't have arms. I think my mom or my then-girlfriend, now wife, dropped me off. And I was walking around just heartbroken. And I remember walking down this path in the woods, and I saw another woman. She was maybe like, 60, walking slow. And I looked at her, and I realized that at some point in her life, and maybe right now, she had experienced the pain that I was currently experiencing. And my heart broke. But there are two ways a heart can break. It can break closed, that hardens you and makes you less available and constricts you. Or your heart can break open, and it can be one of the biggest turning points in your spiritual evolution to open up that well of compassion and love and connectedness to others. And in that moment, on that day, that's what happened to me. My heart broke open, and I loved that stranger. And I have talked about this extensively with clients where, we have different kind of clients, but often someone comes where they are just in crisis, they had a tragedy in their lives, and they need to get through it right now. And this is an idea that we talk about that we sort of guide the client toward, is that idea of your heart can break open, and this can be a catalyst for your continued spiritual advancement, and it can be the best thing that's ever happened to you. This can be something that doesn't break you, but it serves you. And it's very simple imagery of imagine like a heart breaking closed that just shrinks and gets small, or a heart breaking open that just radiates out love and light and compassion. When you can, and I have clients draw out that imagery and identify with it and put it on their nightstand during difficult times. Because when you get that cue that, yes, my heart broke, but it's going to break open in a way that ultimately serves me and the people around me and allows me to connect to souls around me in a much deeper, more meaningful way, then our heartaches become blessings, whether it's in an intimate relationship or missing out on some great opportunity in your profession or your passions. It really doesn't matter. You get to make the conscious decision, because something terrible will happen to you, whether by tragedy or malevolence, but you get to decide, is this something that's going to break me closed or break me open? And in that really determines the quality of your life and really shapes your destiny. So I certainly don't hope that your heart is broken, but if it is, I encourage you to allow your heart to break open in a way where this becomes a way to further your connection with others rather than a means of isolating yourself. And if you do that, our darkest, worst days can become our best days. And if you have those, I hope you're able to break open so you can better serve the people around you and continue enjoying this miracle of life that we do in a way that is most aligned with your soul and who you were destined to be.